Welcome to your viewers for the lecture in the subject design of reinforced concrete structures. Now this is lecture number 158. Already we have discussed about the design of ground level circular tanks. Now we are going to take up underground tanks. And before starting the lectures, some viewers are continuously asking for my numbers. This is my contact number and this is my WhatsApp number, because people regularly used to ask my number. So right now, coming to the subject, now we will discuss the behavior of the side walls first. Now an underground water tank will be subjected to water pressure from inside and earth pressure from outside. So the behavior we have to clearly understand, because when we do a numerical example, we will not be able to elaborately discuss the design concept. Therefore, first in this lecture we will discuss the design concepts, then in the next lecture we will take up the numerical design problem on underground water tanks. Right now, so there may be water pressure from inside and earth pressure or soil pressure from outside. These are the pressures. Coming to the soil may be saturated, soil may be dry or saturated. The soil may be dry or saturated. Right. Now there are number of cases for which we can design the tank. The worst will be that of when the tank is empty, subjected to earth pressure from outside. Even in that, the worst condition will be that of the saturated soil from outside. Tank empty and the soil pressure from outside. This is a regular, whenever we clean the tank for maintenance purposes, this will be there. Many times the tank will be empty, the soil pressure will be acting from outside. This is quite common. The other one is no soil pressure, water pressure from inside. Actually, this is a very rare case. This will occur only once in a lifetime of the tank, because some of the clients will be testing for leakage before backfilling. Only in that case it will be free from soil pressure, but this will not be always occurring. But still, in case if it is designed for leakage before backfilling, then this condition will be there, and that too when it is subjected to, say, saturated soil pressure. Right. Now we will just discuss only these two. Other cases we will omit. One is empty without any water, soil pressure from outside. The other one is water pressure from inside, no soil pressure from outside. These are the things for which we will discuss the concept. Now, coming to the design of the side wall, as far as roof slab is concerned, when the longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension is less than 2, when longer plan dimension capital L by smaller plan dimension small l less than 2, there is one design procedure for the walls. When longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension more than or equal to 2, there is another design procedure. Right. Now, as far as the roof slab is, because we have designed mainly four components. One is the design of the roof slab. Number two, the design of the side walls. We are going to concentrate only on underground rectangular tanks. Right. Then we have got the base slab. These are the components. Roof slab, side walls, side wall in which longer wall and the shorter walls, and then base slab. Right. Now, when capital L by small l is less than 2, as far as the roof slab is concerned, it will be designed as a two-way slab. Actually, coming to the roof slab, when capital L by small l less than or equal to 2, less than or equal to 2, it will be designed as a two-way slab. When capital L by small l is more than 2, it will be designed as a one-way slab. It is assumed to behave along the shorter span direction, one-way slab. This is as far as the roof slab is concerned. Right. Coming to the side walls, now when longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension is less than 2, let us take this wall. Right. It is, let us reduce the length. Right. When this is the case, it is subjected to water pressure from inside. The water pressure will be W into H, where H is the height of storage of water. If the side wall is of height H, if the depth of the water is small h, then you know the water pressure diagram will be a triangle having a maximum ordinate of maximum value of W into H as far as water pressure is concerned. Water pressure. So W into H is the water pressure at a depth H from the top. Right. Now, due to this water pressure, when capital L by small l is less than 2, the side walls will behave as horizontal continuous slabs. Therefore, it will behave like this. That is, this is going to be the behavior of the walls. So this will be the behavior due to the water pressure. Therefore, at the center along the midspan, the tension will occur on the outer side. Tensional cracks will occur on the outer. This is the plan and its the behavior of the walls. Therefore, the tensile cracks will occur on the outside. And at the corners, we will have tensile cracks near the water side. Here you will have the tensile cracks. So these are the tensile cracks. That's about the location of the tensile cracks near the corners. Therefore, if this is the plan of the tank, it will be a horizontal continuous slab as we have discussed here. Therefore, the steel will be provided in the horizontal direction away from the water side at the midspan, right? So this is, the steel will be in the horizontal direction provided away from the water side at the mid span. And here also we will be providing the steel in the horizontal direction for all the four walls. The main reinforcement will be provided in the horizontal direction and away from the water side at the mid span. And here also it will be provided. This is the location and the direction of the main reinforcement. Right. Near the corners, the tension occurs on the inside. Therefore, we have to provide on the inner side, near the water side. Near the water side, we have to provide. So, this is to explain the behavior and location of the main reinforcement for the bending moment. This is about the location of, because with these things cannot be discussed along with a numerical example. So we have to be very clear about the behavior of the side walls. So here all the four walls will be acting as a horizontal continuous slab, and that is about the location and the direction of the main reinforcement. And distribution steel will be in the vertical direction. Right. Again, we are discussing about the design of an underground tank. Right. Now, and we have discussed only about the water pressure. The other case is the tank may be empty, then it may be subjected to soil pressure from outside. The other case. So, this is the case. So, when it is subjected to soil pressure from outside, you know, the soil pressure is equal to Ka into gamma into H at the bottom. If this is water pressure, it is W into H. If it is soil pressure, then the pressure at the bottom will be this value will be Ka into gamma into H. It is also a triangular pressure diagram, right? So it is Ka into gamma H, where Ka equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. As we have learnt from retaining walls, 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi, when the backfill is horizontal, Ka into gamma into H. Right. Now it is subjected to soil pressure from outside. So the behavior will be exactly opposite. That is, here the tension will occur on the inner side and here it will occur on the outside. So I think the viewers can understand. The just opposite will be the behavior. Because of the soil pressure, it will be in the opposite direction. Therefore, for the soil pressure from outside, now the steel will be, main steel will be in the horizontal direction on the water side, and here it will be at the corners. So therefore, coming to underground tanks, we have to be careful, because we will be requiring steel on both sides. One is for water pressure, the other one is for soil pressure. So this is the reinforcement. So this is for water, this is for water pressure, and this is for soil pressure. So this is here, this is for soil pressure, and inner, this is for water pressure. So that is about the location of main reinforcement alone when the side wall behaves as a horizontal continuous slab. In addition, we have distributors, then bottom 1 meter cantilevering effect, and so on. That we will discuss when we discuss the numerical example. So we will just stop the design of the discussion on the design of underground rectangular tanks with the capital L by small l less than 2 with this. Then we will take the next case. Other things we will discuss in the numerical example. Right. Now the next case is when capital L, longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension more than or equal to 2, more than or equal to 2. So here the longer walls will be designed as vertical cantilevers. So here this is capital L, this is small L. Now the longer walls will be designed as vertical cantilevers, vertical cantilevers. For the entire height it will be having cantilevering effect. Therefore when you see the cross section of a longer wall, this is the cross section of a longer wall. Let us assume water up to the top. Actually there will be free board. Anyway, we'll just assume water for the entire height, and if H is the height of storage of water, you can use either capital H or small H, anything can be used. H is meant for the height of water, right? Now here when this is subjected to water pressure, first case let us say water pressure from inside, water pressure, and no soil pressure. Water pressure from inside and no soil pressure from outside. Right. Now if this is the case, the water pressure diagram will be a triangle, will be a triangle whose value is equal to W into H. Intensity of water pressure is equal to W into H. So this will be the pressure to which the side wall will be subjected to. Side wall will be subjected to. Therefore, the total pressure will be, the total pressure P will be equal to half into WH into H. Half into WH into capital H, of course, capital H. That is equal to WH square by 2. And as a cantilever, this will be acting at a height of h by 3 from the base. Therefore bending moment equal to W into H cube by 6. So W into H cube by 6 will be the maximum bending moment. It will be acting at h by 3 from the bottom. So due to this, this will have cantilevering effect. Will be having a cantilevering effect. Therefore, for this cantilever effect, we will have tension on the inner side. So the long wall, so this is the cross section of long wall, cross section of longer wall. Therefore, this will be acting as a cantilever for the whole height. Therefore, the main reinforcement for this cantilever will be vertical, and it will be on the water side. This will be the main steel. This is the main steel. This is on the water side. So the steel in the steel is in the vertical direction. Vertical direction. And of course, distributors will be in the horizontal direction. So the distributors will discuss when you do the problem. We will concentrate on the behavior, where tension occurs, where you have to provide the steel, and in what direction we have to provide this. That is what we are going to concentrate first. Right. So this is about the wall. Right. Then it may be subjected to earth pressure from outside. Earth pressure from outside. Therefore, when this wall is subjected to earth pressure from outside, we know the earth pressure diagram will be a triangle whose value equal to Ka into gamma into H. We know. So here the total pressure is equal to Ka into gamma into H square by 2. Okay. So this we have studied in retaining walls. So total pressure is equal to Ka into gamma into H square by 2. And that will be acting at, so this is total pressure. So this will be again acting at H by 3 from the bottom. So the bending moment due to the soil pressure will be bending moment equal to Ka into gamma into H cube by 6. Here it is simply W H cube by 6. Now here it is Ka into gamma into H cube by 6, where gamma is a unit weight of soil, W is a unit weight of water. We have differentiated. This is unit weight of water, this is unit weight of soil, Ka into gamma into H cube by 6. So due to this, the wall will be acting as a cantilever like this. Will be acting like a cantilever like this. Therefore, for this, the tension will occur on the earth side. On the earth side. Therefore, for that, we have to provide the steel on the outer side. So this is the main steel. So when we design both for water pressure as well as soil pressure, we have to be doubly careful. So this is the main steel for water pressure on the inner side. So this is the main steel. Main steel. This is due to soil pressure. Soil pressure. Right. Also, suppose we take the first case, namely water pressure only. Water pressure only means, so the water pressure acting on the short wall will be transferred to the long wall as tension. But still we have not started the discussion on short walls. The shorter walls, bottom H by 4 or 1 meter will behave as a cantilever as far as the short walls are concerned. Bottom 1 meter or H by 4 will act as a cantilever. Above 1 meter, the short wall will behave as if it is fixed between the long walls. Fixed between the long walls. Right. So that will come little later before that. So above 1 meter or H by 4 from the bottom, it will act as a slab fixed between the long walls. Right. So the pressure 1 meter from the base will be W into H minus 1. W into H minus 1 per meter run. W into H minus 1. Because we are not considering up to the bottom, we are considering a level 1 meter from the bottom. 1 meter from the bottom. Therefore, this is H minus 1. So above 1 meter from the bottom, the pressure is equal to W into H minus 1 meter. Right. Now, this pressure acting on the long wall of length L, suppose this is L, for want of space I am just drawing on this side. So this is the long wall, this is the long wall, this is the short wall, this is the pressure which is W into H minus 1 per unit length. Therefore, here as far as the short walls are concerned, we will have the reaction here, we will have the reaction here. Now this reaction will be W into H minus 1 is the pressure per meter length at a level 1 meter above the bottom. So this is per meter into L by 2 will be the reaction here. Will be the, so W into H minus 1 into L by 2. So this is the reaction. Now the reaction in the short wall will be acting as tension in the long wall. So this value is also equal to W into H minus. So this tension is equal to W into H minus 1 into L by 2. Right. Now, so for this tension, we have to provide steel in the horizontal direction. It is a pull, it's a direct tension. So that tension for which you have to provide the steel in the horizontal direction. So that steel will be providing here. We'll be providing the steel for the tension will be provided in the horizontal. So the entire length of the short wall will transfer the load to the long wall as tension. So as far as the longer walls are concerned, the steel for bending moment will be, because entire height of the wall will be acting as a cantilever. Only thing is, for the water pressure, we have to provide the steel on the water side, inner side. For soil pressure, we have to provide the steel on the other side, namely soil side. So both will be there. So one is for the soil pressure, the other one is for the water pressure. So that's about the main reinforcement as far as the longer walls are concerned. Right. For longer walls, the horizontal steel will be consisting of either the distribution steel, which will be minimum value 0.3%, or the steel required for the tension. So we have to check for the minimum steel here. Suppose the steel required for this, because this is direct tension, the steel required will be sigma st for the tension will be W into H minus 1 into L by 2 divided by sigma st, divided by sigma st. This is AST. Area of steel will be the force divided by stress, direct stress. So W into H minus 1 into L by 2 and by 2 into sigma st. So T by sigma st, or that is a tension divided by sigma st. As we have discussed, it is a tension divided by sigma. It's a direct force, tension divided by sigma st. For this we have to provide the steel in the horizontal direction. So this is due to the water pressure. Due to the water pressure from the short wall to the long wall, whatever is the reaction in the short wall will be transferred to the long wall as tension, whose value equal to W into H minus 1 into L by 2. So that is a tension for which you have to provide the steel in the horizontal direction. So this is when water pressure is acting. Right. Now in the same wall, when soil pressure acts, forget about this. Suppose the wall is subjected to soil pressure. So soil pressure again at 1 meter above the base, we know it is Ka into gamma into H. Here again minus 1. Because again bottom 1 meter we will have cantilevering effect. As far as the short walls are concerned, bottom 1 meter it will be a cantilever. The above 1 meter it will be treated as fixed between the long walls. So bottom 1 meter will have only cantilevering effect. So here also Ka into gamma into H minus 1 again at a level 1 meter above the base. 1 meter base. So this is per meter run. Right. Now coming to the longer wall. So if this is the shorter wall, now this is the reaction. The reaction in the shorter wall will be Ka into gamma into H minus 1 per meter run into L by 2 will be the reaction. So here also same reaction, Ka into gamma into H minus 1 L by 2. So that is a reaction here also, right? Now this is connected to the long wall. This is connected to the long wall. This reaction will be acting as a tension. Will be acting as a will be right. So this is the reaction. This is the reaction in the short wall. So the reaction is say towards left as far as the wall and the left hand side is concerned. The reaction is towards left, opposite to this, right? Now this will be acting as compression. This will be acting as a compression. Therefore, when water pressure acts, the long walls will be subjected to tension. Now when soil pressure acts, the longer valve will be subjected to compression, direct compression. So this value equal to Ka into gamma into H minus 1 into L by 2. So that is, so the longer wall will be subjected to compression, previously it was subjected to tension, now the longer wall will be subjected to compression. Therefore for this we have to provide the steel again in the horizontal direction, both for compression as well as tension. We have to provide the steel in the horizontal direction, and when it is subjected to tension, that will cause one bending moment. We have to find out the resultant bending moment. That we will discuss later. The resultant bending moment will be given by M minus T into X. So what is M, what is T, what is X? How to find out the resultant bending moment, we will discuss a little later. So the longer walls will be designed for bending moment, resultant bending moment. Then tension, we have to provide steel for the resultant moment, steel for tension, and we have to complete the design. So main thing is the main reinforcement on the outer side as well as on the inner side, and this horizontal steel are to be provided for taking the tension in the long wall due to water pressure, or compression in the long wall due to soil pressure. So the force, nature of force varies. It varies from tension to compression. So that is about the long wall. We have just discussed only the behavior of the long walls, and the direction and the location of the reinforcement for the long walls when capital L by small l is equal to or more than 2. Right. Now we'll take up the design of the, because this I cannot discuss when you do a numerical example. I'll not be able to discuss so elaborately when we do a numerical problem. That is why. But anyway, if the viewers got enough idea about the behavior, then design will not be difficult. But you have to understand all these things. Water pressure, soil pressure, tension, compression, everything. That you have to be very strong. Then the design will be easy. Right. And I have not given the formula for the tension in the earlier bending mode in the earlier case. That we will discuss along with the numerical exam, no problem. What is the bending mode, the center, what is the bending mode, the corners, that we are supposed to have discussed in the first case. Anyway, that we will discuss along with the numerical example. Don't worry, I will not. Right. Now, coming to short wall. Shorter wall. Now we are concentrating on the case of a tank with the capital L by small l more than or equal to 2. We have completed longer walls. So this we have completed. How to design the shorter wall? The shorter wall, bottom 1 meter, it will have a cantilevering effect. Bottom 1 meter, it will be having a cantilever effect. Actually, bottom 1 meter or h by 4, whichever is more, normally we will be providing the depth of the tank as 3 meters, 3.5 meters, etc. Therefore, normally 1 meter will be more, whichever is more, 1 meter or h by 4. Therefore, normally that 1 meter will be more. Therefore, we can just take it as 1 meter because we will not be going for more than 4 meters, right? Therefore, of course, excepting large tanks will go for more depth. When the tank is of very large size, carrying water 1 lakh liters, 2 lakh liters, there you will go for more than 4 meters. Generally, for tanks, it will be around 3 to 4 meters only. Therefore, generally, this 1 meter will be the higher value. Therefore, bottom 1 meter will have a cantilevering effect. So, here, if this is the side wall, so now this bottom 1 meter or h by 4 will have cantilevering effect. 1 meter, right. Now, for this, when it is subjected to water pressure from inside, you know, water pressure is equal to W into H. This is the water pressure diagram, water pressure, W into H. Therefore, we will be designing this as a vertical cantilever for which you will provide the steel on the inner side. You know the behavior, already we discussed about the behavior of a long wall when it is subject to water pressure from inside. Now, when this is designed for water pressure from inside, we will be considering only this part of the diagram. If this is 1 meter, we will be considering only this part of the water pressure diagram for the design. We will discuss with respect to the numerical example. So, with the 0 at the top, WH at the bottom, this is the water pressure diagram that will be considered, not this value. This value we will not be considering. We will be considering this part of the diagram as the pressure diagram. This is W and H only, where H is the total height of this. So, this is total height. That will be taking, but this pressure will be considered at the bottom. Here we will be having 0. So, only this pressure diagram we will be considering in the design of the bottom 1 meter height for the cantilever effect, right? So, that is about the water pressure diagram. So, for which we will be providing the steel for a cantilever in the vertical direction, right? Now, coming to soil pressure, so that is one case. That is case number 1. Second case, if we design for soil pressure from outside, you know, this is a Ka into gamma into H. So, this is the soil pressure, right? Now, when this is considered for the analysis, you know, tension will occur on the soil side. Therefore, for this, we have to provide the steel in the vertical direction on the soil side. So, that is as far as the bottom 1 meter. So, we have designed for both. So, that is case 2 will be, one case will be, that is design of shorter wall. First, bottom 1 meter. Case number 1. Subjected to water pressure from inside, no soil pressure from outside. Case number 2. Subject to soil pressure from outside, no water pressure from tank is empty. These are the 2 conditions for which we are going to design. So, for this, the behavior and also the direction of the main steel for the bottom 1 meter or H by 4 is this. That is one design. Then we have to go for the distribution steel. Then, next one is, we have to above 1 meter. So that is this height. This height will be h minus 1. H minus 1. Right. So above 1 meter, the wall, the shorter wall will behave as if it is fixed between the long walls. That is, this is the shorter wall, this is the longer wall, it will be treated as fixed between the long walls. So this will be treated as fixed between the long walls. So this is L, right. It will be treated as fixed between the long walls. Right. Now here, this will be subjected to water pressure from inside. There are two cases. One is water pressure, the other one is soil pressure. Right. So the water pressure at a level 1 meter above the base will be W into H minus 1 per meter run. W into H minus 1. Let us call this as P. P equal to W into H minus 1. Right. Now, we know when a fixed beam, is subjected to, a load of P per unit length, we know the fixed moment will be WL square by 12 on the left hand side, plus WL square by 12 on the right hand side. This is a support moment diagram whose value equal to PL square by 12, right. Now coming to simply supported moment diagram, it is a parabola having a maximum value of PL square by 8. This we know. Already we know. Right. Right. Now therefore the net value will be, the net value here will be PL square by 12 minus PL square by 8. This will be equal to PL square by 24. That will be the value. Right. The same thing. If it is a fixed beam, we can understand. Now coming to this same diagram. This is the support moment diagram. This is PL square by 12, where P equal to W into H minus 1. PL square by 12. This is also PL square by 12. And coming to simply supported moment diagram, so this will be a parabola. And we find that the net value here will be, PL square by 24. So that will be treated as fixed between the long walls. So these are the bending moments. Right. Now, for this bending moment, I'll just draw the diagram here. Because this requires lot of explanation with illustrative sketches. If this is clearly understood, any numerical example available in any book will make it clear about the understanding of the design. Right. So this is the shorter wall. Now for this, you know, the tension will occur on the inner side. So this will cause tension. You know, we can understand when the water pressure is from here, we know this will behave as a slab like this. Therefore here we will have tension. So above 1 meter level, the steel will be in the horizontal direction away from the water side, and at the corners the steel will be provided near the corners where tension occurs, we have to provide. So for a length equal to L, the steel will be in the horizontal direction. This is above 1 meter, and here the steel will be in the, so if it is midspan section, if this is midspan section, the steel will be provided, here, due to the water pressure, steel will be provided away from the water side. Therefore, here, the steel will be provided in the horizontal direction. So, this will look like dots This is the main reinforcement for 1 meter above the bottom, above the bottom. So this is for the main, this is the main reinforcement for the water pressure at a level 1 meter above. Therefore, for the bottom 1 meter, for cantilever you will have the seal like this. Above 1 meter, for the slab fixed between the long walls, this will be the main reinforcement. The main reinforcement. Similarly. So this is at the center. Suppose if it is at the corner, if the same side wall section is at the corners, the steel will be on this side. The steel will be on the outer side. Steel will be on the outer side. I will not be able to show both in the same diagram. Suppose if it is a corner section, the main reinforcement for a level 1 meter above will be on this side. This is a corner section. So these things one has to be very strong, without which the design will not be clear, and you'll be drawing simply without understanding the design or concept. We'll be just drawing, ultimately we'll just draw number of lines, number of dots, without understanding. So this is what is happening in many cases. Even in some of the books also, you can just, you have to verify once, because finally where we are providing them. So but if we design the reinforcement like this, we will be adopting some effective depth. Instead of providing the steel on the outer side, if you provide the distribution steel on the outer side and provide the main steel on the inner side, then the effective depth will become less. When the effective depth becomes less, the QBD square, the moment of resistance, will become less. The structure may not be adequate. Therefore, what it is designed, where we have designed the main reinforcement, we have to provide, if it is on the outer side, we have to provide only on the outer side. Instead, during drawing, when you provide the steel on the inner side, the effective depth will become less, the momentary resistance will become less, ultimately the section may not meet the requirement. So these are all the things that have to be concentrated, right? So that is about the steel, right? Now coming to the next one, namely, and therefore for this you have to provide the seal in the distribution seal in the vertical direction. So we are just concentrating only on the main seal. We will avoid a distribution seal now. Distribution seal we will do it when you do the numerical design, right? We will concentrate only on the behavior and the main reinforcement, right? Now when the wall is subjected to soil pressure from inside, soil pressure from outside, the same wall, instead of water pressure, it is subjected to soil pressure from outside. Because for both we are designing for tank empty, subjected to soil pressure, the tank full, there is no air pressure. These are the two cases. So here again, let us say P dash is the soil pressure. P dash at a level 1 meter above the base will be Ka into gamma into H minus 1 per meter. Pa equal to Ka into gamma into Ka gamma into H minus 1 at a level 1 meter. Therefore, instead of this, when the pressure is that of soil pressure acting from outside, we know that the behavior will be like this. So this will be the side on which tension occurs. Therefore, we have to provide the steel on the inner side. The main steel over the midspan section will be designed on the inner side in the horizontal direction, because this is the plan. So the steel will be on the inner side, and near the corners we will have. So this behavior one can easily understand. This is in the plan. Therefore, the steel will be provided, if it is a midspan section, the steel will be provided here at the midspan section. It will be provided on the soil side. So here, this is the corner section, this is for water, and this is for soil pressure. So here this is for water, this is for water, and this is for soil. So that is about the main reinforcement for the two cases. Then of course we have to provide the distribution steel. Actually for this we have to provide vertical distribution steel. Here also we have to provide vertical distribution steel. Here we have to provide horizontal distribution steel. All those things we will discuss in the numerical example. Therefore one must be able to draw the cross section. You have to understand the behavior clearly. Tension, where tension occurs, where steel is to be provided, in what direction it is to be provided. So how to draw it in the plan, how to draw it in the cross section. If these things are understood, numerical problem will be easier, very easier, right? So that is about the behavior of the long wall and short wall when the longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension is more than or equal to 2. Therefore not only the cross section, now we have discussed the cross section in the plan also. Suppose this is the longer wall, this is the shorter wall. Longer walls, the steel for the bending moment will be in the vertical direction. Therefore in the plan it look like dots. This is for the for water pressure it will be acting from inside. So for water pressure it will be looking like dots on the water side. What it looks like, this is shorter wall, that is shorter wall. Anyway, for longer wall it will be a vertical reinforcement near the water side. This is for water pressure. For soil pressure it will be on the inner side, it will be on the outer side, on the backfill side. This is in the plan. In the cross section we have seen that this steel will be on the water side and this steel will be on the soil side for the what, soil pressure. So this will be looking as dots in the plan. Sometimes in there is a possibility that this reinforcement will be shown on the outer side and the distribution steel will be provided on the inside. So this is wrong. You have to be strong in your concept, because if you draw like this the effective depth will become less, moment resistance will become less, that will not serve the purpose. Therefore these things you have to just clearly understand and then we have to provide the distribution steel, or you can say the steel for the pull, that you have to just provide on the inner side. Similarly, depending upon the level, whether this is bottom 1 meter or above 1 meter, you have to provide the steel. What looks like lines here will be looking like dots here. What looks like dots here will look like lines here. So that is about some approximate idea about the plan. We have not discussed one more point, so that I want to just discuss now. So coming to the shorter wall, we know that bottom 1 meter we have completed for the cantilever effect. Above 1 meter we have discussed only for the bending moment due to the water pressure from inside and the next soil pressure from outside, right? Now from the longer wall, the shorter wall will also be subjected to tension. So for the shorter wall we have to provide steel in the horizontal direction. That is, here the entire length of the longer wall will not transfer the load to the short wall. About 1 meter length from either end. So this will transfer the load to this wall and this will transfer the load to this wall. Therefore about 1 meter length of the long wall, so entire length of long wall will not transfer the force to the short wall. So here the pressure is equal to W into H minus 1 into 1 meter, of course only 1 meter. Therefore that will be transferring the load to, so this will be the reaction. Now this reaction will be transferred to the short wall as tension. So it is W into H minus 1 into, of course, only 1 meter. 1 meter. That will be the tension that is transferred from the long wall to the short wall. Now for this tension, we have to provide the steel in the horizontal direction. The steel in horizontal direction. Steel in the horizontal, yes, direction. And here also, for a length of 1 meter, that will be subjected to tension. This is due to the water pressure. Suppose if it is subject to earth pressure from outside, so this will be acting from outside as earth pressure, again 1 meter length, it will be acting. Now this value will be Ka into gamma into H minus 1. So that will be the tension, that will be the compression, because when the force is acting from outside, this will be having the reaction in this direction. So coming to the short wall, this will be acting as a compression. So when the wall will be subjected to tension, when the wall will be subjected to compression, and whether it is tension or compression, the steel will be in the horizontal direction. Therefore, above 1 meter, as far as the shorter walls are concerned, the steel for pull or steel for compression will be in the horizontal direction. Therefore, above 1 meter, the steel for bending moment will be in the horizontal direction. The steel for pull will also be in the horizontal direction. Steel for bending moment will be in the, so this is the short wall, the steel for bending moment will be in the horizontal direction. The steel for pull also will be in the horizontal direction. So the short wall above 1 meter level will have to be designed for the combined effect of bending moment and pull, or bending moment and compression. So it is not only for bending moment, because both steel happens to be in the horizontal direction. So these things will have to be thoroughly understood. Then roof slab, we can design one-way slab or two-way slab. Coming to the bottom slab, will have to be, when it is the case of an underground tank, the bottom slab we have to design for uplift pressure also, because when the tank is empty, sometimes the weight of the wall, weight of the roof slab, weight of the base slab, etc., will be less than the uplift pressure. So when you want to be, when you want the tank to be safe against uplift pressure, you have to find out the difference in weight, and accordingly you have to provide projection all round the tank, sufficient length on all round the tank. Base slab will have to be extended so that the earth resting on the projections will serve as safety. And so what length we have to provide, how to design the base slab, so that we will discuss when we take the numerical example. So this is some overall idea about the design of an underground rectangular tank. In the subsequent classes, we will take the numerical example for design. Right. Thank you for your cooperation. Thank you.